you know that four-sided polygons are known as quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals is a term derived from two Latin terms, quadri, meaning four, and lattice, meaning sides. So four-sided polygons are known as quadrilaterals. Now we have studied that any quadrilateral having four sides can be represented in this way. Now we are going to talk about certain quadrilaterals and try to group them with the help of some common characteristics. Now if you look at the quadrilaterals that have been shown on the screen, can you tell me if there is anything common in between them? If you look closely, you will find that they seem to be having opposite pair of parallel sides. For example, in this quadrilateral, these two sides are parallel. In this quadrilateral, these two sides are parallel. In this quadrilateral, these two sides are parallel. So, in a similar manner, all these quadrilaterals have at least one pair of sides which are parallel to one another. And these kinds of quadrilaterals have a particular name, that is trapezium. These kinds of quadrilaterals are known as trapezium. So let us see what is a defining characteristic of a trapezium. In a trapezium, at least one pair of sides is parallel. So in this case, this side and this side, that is one pair of sides, is parallel. The parallel sides of a trapezium are known as the bases. So over here, this side and this side are known as the bases of the trapezium. And as you can see, the other two sides are non-parallel. So these non-parallel sides are known as legs. Now there is also a special case of a trapezium. That special case is known as isosceles trapezium. Now in an isosceles trapezium, the non-parallel side, that is, the legs of the trapezium, are equal to one another. So while we have these opposite pair of sides that are parallel to one another, as you can see, the non-parallel sides are equal to one another. This kind of a trapezium is known as isosceles trapezium. The word isosceles is derived from two Greek words, isos, which means equal, and skelos, which means leg. So it means that this is a trapezium which has equal legs. Now look at these three figures. They have been marked out as figure 1, figure 2, and figure 3. Now I have a question for you. Do you think that any of these figures is a trapezium? Let us analyze them one by one. If we consider figure 1, we can easily say that this is not a trapezium. Because for a trapezium, there should be at least one pair of sides that is parallel. And over here, we cannot have any parallel sides. These two sides are not parallel, and neither are these two sides. So despite it being a quadrilateral having four sides, this figure is not a trapezium. Now let us consider figure 2. Over here, we have one pair of parallel sides. That is, this side is parallel to this side. But even then, it is not a trapezium. Why? Because a trapezium, first and foremost, is a quadrilateral. What is a quadrilateral? A polygon with four sides. Over here, as you can see, this polygon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides. So clearly, even this figure is not a trapezium. And now let us consider figure 3. Over here we find that there are four sides again. So it is a quadrilateral, but as is evident from the figure, there are no parallel sides. So this side is not parallel to this side, neither is this side parallel to this side. So no pair of opposite sides are parallel to one another. So even figure 3 is not a trapezium. Now we consider a special case of a trapezium. Over here, as you can find, certain trapezium have been shown. That is, one pair of parallel sides has been shown. Now, do you think there is something more to these figures? If you observe closely, it becomes apparent that there are something more to all these figures. There is one more pair of parallel sides in each of these cases. So if I consider the first figure, I can see that these two sides, that is this pair of sides, is also parallel to one another. Even in the second figure, this particular pair of sides are also parallel to one another. And in a similar way, we will see that all these figures have two pairs of opposite sides that are parallel to one another. So such kinds of quadrilaterals are known as parallelograms, which are a special kind or a special case of trapezium. In parallelograms, both the pairs of sides are parallel to one another. As you can see, in this, this pair is parallel to one another, and this pair is also parallel to one another. Now we consider certain special cases of a parallelogram. Now in a parallelogram, as you can see, there are four angles because it is a quadrilateral. Now if I consider one angle as a right angle, I get a special case of a parallelogram. So over here I have considered this angle as a right angle. And keeping the view of a parallelogram that opposite pair of sides have to be parallel, I get a special kind of parallelogram, that is a rectangle. Rect angle means right angle. So over here, since one angle is a right angle, this kind of parallelogram is known as a rectangle. Now I can also have another case of a parallelogram. In that case, keeping the same view that opposite sides are parallel, that is, this side is parallel to this side, and this side is parallel to this side. I have adjacent sides equal. That is, this particular side equal to this particular side, or this particular side equal to this particular side. So when adjacent sides are equal, I have a parallelogram that is known as a rhombus. Now I can further the properties using the properties of rectangle as well as that of a rhombus. Now combining both these properties, I can come up with even a special type of parallelogram. Now in a rectangle, it is a parallelogram with one right angle. And a rhombus is a parallelogram with adjacent sides equal. So if I combine these two properties, what kind of parallelogram will I get? I will get a parallelogram which has one right angle as well as adjacent sides equal. Thus, I get another special kind of parallelogram that is known as a square. In a square, as you can see, one of the angles is a right angle and we have adjacent sides as equal. And also, opposite sides are parallel to one another. Now we talk about a very special kind of quadrilaterals that are known as kites. Now you must have flown a kite when you were young, or even if you haven't flown a kite, you must have definitely seen a kite being flown. Now if you have observed closely, the shape of a kite is somewhat as has been shown in this figure, a regular kite. So a kite is also a special kind of quadrilateral. What are the properties of a kite? Quadrilaterals with two pairs of equal adjacent sides. So over here, if I consider these two sides, that is this particular pair, since they are adjacent, they will be equal. Also, if I consider this pair, these two sides, they will also be equal. So quadrilaterals with two pairs of equal and adjacent sides are known as kites. This kind of a kite is known as a convex kite. Similarly, we have a concave kite, also known as an arrowhead. And the same property holds for an arrowhead as well. Adjacent sides are equal to one another. So we have two pairs of equal adjacent sides. And such quadrilaterals are kites. Now take a look at this picture. If you observe it closely, you will find that there seems to be some sort of a spherical bulge, something that seems to be coming out. Now, do you think that there is indeed a sphere embedded? The answer is no. This picture is purely made up of quadrilaterals, that is, rectangles. Now, why does it seem that something is bulging out? That is because these rectangles have been arranged in such a manner that they are forming an illusion which is deceiving your eyes. So it is due to this that it seems that this picture has something bulging out, where in reality, if you observe really closely, you will find that it is nothing but arrangement of rectangles in a particular fashion. So now we move and proceed to classify the number of quadrilaterals we have read about so far. We summarize how many kinds of quadrilaterals we talked about. So firstly, we have a general quadrilateral, that is any given quadrilateral whose sum of interior angles is equal to 360 degrees and no other special property. We also talked about kites, which has adjacent pair of sides equal, and there are two such pairs. We also talked about trapezium, where at least one pair of opposite sides are parallel to one another. And also we considered several cases of trapezium. We considered isosceles trapezium, where one pair of opposite sides is parallel and the non-parallel sides are equal to one another. We also considered another case of trapezium, that was a parallelogram, where both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel to one another. Next, we moved on to classify certain special kinds of parallelograms. And we came up with rhombus, where opposite sides are parallel to one another and adjacent sides are equal. We moved on further to rectangles. In rectangles, again, opposite sides are parallel to one another and one angle is equal to 90 degrees. Combining the properties of rhombus and rectangle, we moved on to yet another special kind of parallelogram. That is a square. A square combines both the properties of rectangle as well as rhombus. So it means that keeping opposite sides parallel to one another, we have one angle that is 90 degrees and adjacent sides are equal. So that gave us a square combining both properties of rectangle and rhombus. So now let us group the entire quadrilaterals that we've studied about in a Venn diagram. So over here, the black line indicates the universal set. So we have considered the kite that has two pairs of equal adjacent sides and the general quadrilateral. So now we also studied about trapezium, which has at least one pair of parallel sides. We considered a special case of trapezium. We considered isosceles trapezium, where it had one pair of parallel sides and the non-parallel sides were equal to one another. We also considered parallelogram, where both pairs of opposite sides were parallel. We considered special cases of parallelogram, that is a rhombus, where adjacent sides are equal, and rectangle, where one angle is equal to 90 degrees. And combining the properties of rhombus and rectangle, as I have done in this set, we have a square. So it is very clear from this Venn diagram that square is nothing but the amalgamation of rhombus and rectangle. So it has equal adjacent sides and one angle 90 degrees. So thus we have summed up the entire set of quadrilaterals that we studied so far with the help of a neat and understandable Venn diagram.